a particular incident which took place 1979. America had sent a Skylab up there, and there was a heavy rumor everywhere that it was going to fall down. And according to the calculations of all those scientists, the experts, that it was going to fall at the location where Chennai is situated. The Americans predicted that it would fall over Chengalpattu. The Russians predicted that it would be somewhere to the north of Ennore. What a meticulous prediction. And so, it was July 12th, 1979, and Swami was seated there in the veranda of Sanadi Street House. There were about 10 to 12 people, all IAS, IPS, the police higher officials, and the administrators, the high administrators. One devotee by name, Sri Tirumalai, from Kovilpatti. He happened to be there with Swami on that particular day. He was also sitting with them. There was a small transistor in front of Bhagwan, which was announcing, describing the Skylab, its functioning, and how it was going to fall down, and at what time, everything. So a few minutes before its fall, Swami was asking everybody there, what do you think? Where do you think the Skylab would fall? And each one had something to say. You know, they mentioned some place in Chennai, because their guess was based upon what the scientists had predicted. So each one had to say something. And they all agreed that it was going to fall on Chennai, and that's why they were worried, and that's why they were there with Bhagwan. Then Bhagwan, with a radiant face, announced, my father is looking after India from eternity to eternity. No harm will come to India or its people. You will see the Skylab would fall only in the ocean, not on the land. There will be no damage, no harm to the land or the people. My father has been protecting India from eternity to eternity. He would see to it. So minutes after, there was this announcement on the transistor. The Skylab had fallen down, but in the ocean, 35 kilometers away from the land of Chennai, to the east of Chennai, in the Bay of Bengal. So this particular incident, when Swami was announcing that the Skylab would fall only in the ocean, Tirumalai, who was seated there, was thinking, what is this? The Swami is saying something? All those experts, scientists are predicting with all their calculations exactly where it would fall, but the Swami is saying something? Minutes after, when this announcement was made that the Skylab had fallen exactly as predicted by Bhagwan, Tirumalai instantly understood that Bhagwan, that Swami, that beggar was no beggar, no just Swami, he was the cosmic controller. When Sri Tirumalai from Kovilpatti came to the ashram. I think it was 2010 or 11. We were talking to each other. At the time, I was saying that Bhagwan often said, when he would be in a certain mood, he would declare, unmindful of the people around, "I am the cosmic controller. I run the whole cosmos. I alone exist. There is nothing else, no one else." So when I was describing this to Tirumalai, he mentioned this incident, and later, when people were sharing their experiences on the mic in celebration of Aradhana Day, he spoke about it to all those people present. He said, "Amma, whatever you say is absolutely true, because I was the first-hand witness to what happened. I saw with what ease Bhagwan controlled everything and how everything happened exactly to his prediction, to the very letter. It is true that he is the cosmic controller." Bhagwan, from time to time, was declaring it. So we shall submit our prayer today at the lotus feet of this cosmic controller. For some reason, it is the divine that has sent this virus, and the whole world seems to be in the terrible grip of this virus, suffering in agony. This is also part of the divine plan. We do not know what cleansing has taken place. As we see already how nature is responding, how the animal kingdom is responding to the situation. So there must be some cosmic balance. This is what Bhagwan said. From time to time, that Father would send something to restore cosmic balance. So we shall pray to Bhagwan. Bhagwan, now kindly give us a huge grace and free the entire humanity from the clutches of this virus. Please bring normalcy to every aspect of life everywhere. Help all those medical researchers to find a potent vaccine that would work immediately, not take months. And please give a boost to the falling economy. And above all those health workers at the very risk of their life, laboring day and night in order to save other lives. Please give them protection, the health of body and mind, and longevity.